guys, welcome back to my YouTube channel. This is ABM Organic Beauty. If you're new to my channel, kindly subscribe to my channel, like and share my video, and don't forget to turn on your notification bell below. If you don't turn on your notification bell below, there's no way that you will know, or there's no way you'll be notified when I upload a new video. So what are you waiting for? Just turn on the notification bell now. Have you done that? Okay, thank you. Alright, so turn on your notification bell so that you'll be notified when I upload a new video. Today I want to talk about something. The last video I actually dropped on my channel was the turmeric orange brightening bath soap I actually made. Like, seriously guys, I don't know why that video is not having much views now. Is it because it's not whitening? Or is it because I don't just know why? But I think and I feel that people love whitening. Like, you like it when I'm making whitening, when I'm making a whole lot of whitening product on this channel. Why do you even like whitening? I just want to ask for your opinion, because I'm a bit confused. Last year I really did a whole lot of promixing. Yeah, I did a whole lot of whitening on my YouTube channel, but this year I swapped to organic. Like, I've been doing organic this year. Yeah, I've been making organic creams, organic soup this year. I don't think I've done promixing on my channel this year. So now it's time to make a choice. Yeah, I'm not saying whitening is not good. If you want to do whitening, no problem. Because right here, right now, I'm gonna be guiding you on how to go about your skin lightening journey. If you're bleaching, or if you're doing skin lightening, there are ways to do it. There are things to use. There are how to do it so that you will look healthy. It's not like you'll be doing skin lightening and you'll be looking this way. God, I don't want to look that way, even if I should do skin lightening. Do you want to look that way? Okay, now, I'm going to be guiding you on how you can do skin lightening and you will look like this. Wow. Isn't that skin looking beautiful? Yeah, so watch this video to the end. Don't go away. Do you want me to always do promixing on this channel, or you want me to stick to organic on this channel? So just tell me what you want in the commenting box. So let me go into today's talk. Today's topic is support your skin lightening journey by eating those vitamins for a glowing and a clearer skin. Like we all know, so many of us women, we want to tone our skin. So many of us, we are born with a very dark skin and we feel we want to tone our skin. But my dear, we have levels in skin lightening. We have the one we call skin bleaching. We have the one we call skin lightening. Then we have the one we call skin toning. If you ask me which category do I fall under, I would say I fall under the category of skin toning. Yeah, because I actually use plant-based skincare product to tone my skin. Yeah, I was born with a brown skin. I wasn't born with a, you know, caramel skin this way, because yeah, I'll call myself caramel. Am I light? Is my color not caramel? My color is caramel. There was a time I used to be white, but right now I am caramel. Yeah, I had to think about my life. I had to think about my old age, like I always say on this channel. So guys, today I want to tell you steps. I want to tell you procedures. I want to tell you those vitamins you eat to support your skin lightening journey, to support your skin bleaching journey. Now, you shouldn't be looking bleached. You shouldn't be looking all this bad because you want to tone your skin. We have so many international artists that toned their skin. I don't want to mention them, but we have so many stars that were born with dark skin and they tune their skin. And when you see their skin is popping. Even when they tell you that they were born with that dark skin, you will not believe it. Because you want to know why? Apart from applying a lightening or a bleaching product on your skin, the beauty, the main beauty of your skin starts from the inside. Depends on what you eat, what you feed your body from the inside. Whatever you feed your body from the inside is what will reflect on the outer side, on outer surface of your skin. Now, if you're doing skin lightening, you're doing skin toning, or even if you're not doing, this topic is for you today. Because I've seen so many people that they don't even apply skincare products and they glow, they shine. Do you want to know why? Because it's either they place themselves on supplements that will make their skin glow, that will make their skin popping from the inside, or it's either they eat good fruits that hydrates their skin from the inside, that makes them to pop from the inside. I know someone, she does not even apply skincare products, but man, she eats good fruits, she eats good food, she takes water a lot, but she does not spread herself under the sun. No, she's always in the east. So what do you expect? So for you that you're into skin lightening, or even if you're not into skin lightening, as long as you want your skin to pop, as long as you're applying skincare product on your skin, so what you apply on your skin is not enough. Believe me, it's not enough. What makes your skin to radiate from inside has a big role to play to the way our skin will look popping. Now, if you're doing skin lightening, you apply clobestasol on your body, you apply hydroquinone on your body, and in your mind, you feel you're doing skin lightening. My dear, when you apply hydroquinone more than 6 months, you are about killing yourself totally. Yes. Now, even if you want to use HQ, the normal standard usage rate of HQ is 2%. Now, most people uses HQ at 4%. Now, if you are to prescribe HQ at 4%, that has to be prescribed by a pharmacist. Now, even at that 4%, the chemist will have to monitor the usage of that particular cream, hydroquinone cream, you're using at 4%. The usage of that 4% has to be under critical monitoring. Even at that 4%, you shouldn't exceed 6 months. Fine, in most of all our skincare products, most people add hydroquinone. They had it at 2%. They had hydroquinone. But I don't advise you to use hydroquinone for a very long time. Even if you want to achieve skin lightening with hydroquinone, please give it a break. If you've used for 6 months, give it a break. Now, for you that you're using clobestasol, I'll still make a video on clobestasol to actually give you breakdown of this clobestasol. Clobestasol are all these are two creams that contain steroids, just like something like this. This actually contains clobestasol, so this is actually a steroid cream. They call this New Light. I've had it since last year. I actually wanted to didn't make review on it or something. I just digged out this morning. So for you that you use clobestasol has a way you use it. It's not like you just buy clobestasol and you apply clobestasol on your face, or you start applying all this tube cream on your body, then you start applying for a very long time. Then before you know, the next thing you start seeing, your green vein will start coming out. Your skin will look so thin, very, very thin, very, very transparent, that even when they look at your skin this way, they will start seeing all the green vein, all the line. You know, you start having redness here. Your face here will start becoming very, very red. My dear, you don't use skin lightening. You don't use skin lightening creams that way. If you use it that way, you're going to look bad. Believe me, you're going to hate yourself. So now, for those of you that are into skin lightening, there are many good lotions out there in the market that you can actually use to achieve skin lightening. You can actually make yourself. Yeah, on this channel, I have so many videos on how to make your lightening lotions. You can actually make these lotions yourself. If you're applying skin lightening, give your skin a break. Most times, even the way I recommend, apply your skin lightening cream 4 times in a week. Then you apply your moisturizer 3 times in a week. Now, it depends on the heaviness of the lightening properties in that lotion. If probably you're just applying a moisturizer that just contained only Abutin powder, you know that one is purely organic. You don't need to stress yourself. Yeah, because organic cream, they are not quick to action. But when you're applying cream that contains hydroquinone, contains clomestasone, do you want to kill yourself? Please give yourself a break. Apply 3 times in a week, or you apply 4 times in a week. The rest of the days, you apply a moisturizer. So guys, now, apart from following this routine, what we put in our body, what we consume matters. So I'm going to be listing out 5 good vitamins your skin needs. When you're doing skin lightening, 5 good vitamins you have to be on just for you to achieve a flawless, even skin tone with your skin lightening cream. And this also can be used by you that you're not even doing skin lightening, because it really helps a lot. I remember a time I placed myself on omega-3 fatty acid. Oh my God. I was just taking the supplement and people were asking me, what are you using? What are you applying? That glow was too much. Guys, that glow was too much. So I was using omega-3 fatty acid. Then I was also taking my vitamin C. Like, seriously, guys, that glow was too much. Here come the 5 vitamins your skin needs for that glowing and a clearer skin. When you're taking these vitamins and you're doing skin lightening, it will help your skin stand the chemicals that are contained into your lightening skincare products. It will help your skin to stand or to be able to at least fight ash chemicals in your skin lightening products. That is why you need these skin vitamins. And the number one on our list is vitamin C. So vitamin C is known as ascorbic acid. Whenever I'm formulating my lotions, I use my vitamin C powders. Though it depends on my formulation. It depends on whatever product I am formulating. But I use my ascorbic acid. Ascorbic acid is gotten from orange, grapefruits. It's gotten from red sweet pepper. So ascorbic acid is an antioxidant. It helps fight the damages that the sun might bring upon your skin. Vitamin C also is very important in our body for the production of collagen. When you lack vitamin C in you, then you start experiencing skin sagging. The firmness of your skin will be lost. That's when you start experiencing skin wrinkles. So you really need vitamin C in you. You need it in your skincare product. You need it in your body. Another important vitamin you need for your skin, this one is very, very important, is collagen. Yeah, you need collagen for your skin. If you want to get all those products, you can check in my description box below. You'll see the link to where you can order these vitamins from. Collagen is very, very important for everybody. Collagen, you need more collagen in your body than ever. By the time you're more than 30 years, or if you're more than 30 years of age, please believe me that your body produces less collagen. So you need more and more of collagen in your body. Collagen is very, very important for every woman, because if you lack collagen, in fact, you might turn to an old woman in the next 1 year. You see a 30 years old woman looking like a 60 years old woman. I'm telling you. So we need collagen in our body for skin firming. It's one of the most vitality needed in the body for good skin, for good health. Apart from skin, even for good health. Because when you're above 30, you start noticing sign of aging. And if you don't have much collagen in you, you can just wither. You just wither like a 60 years old woman. So guys, we need collagen in our body. We need collagen to stay, for our skin to look young. We need collagen for our skin to look firm. We need collagen to help the elasticity of our skin. That is why collagen is highly needed in you, especially if you're above 30. So the next vitamin I'm going to be talking about is our vitamin A. Yeah. So guys, just to let you know, vitamin A is subdivided into two. We have the retinol. The retinol is being gotten from animal fat. Then we have the beta carotene. Beta carotene, it's called carotenoid. Yeah, the beta carotene is gotten from plants like your carrots, sweet potato, your pumpkin. That's where you get beta carotene from, vitamin A from. You get your retinol from egg, your dairy foods, your beef, I think meat liver. Yeah, you get retinol from that source. So retinol is highly needed in the body. It helps to protect against sun damage and also help in skin inflammations. Probably you're having any skin impediments. Vitamin A helps a lot. So vitamin A helps in reducing fine lines. It helps also in the production of collagen. So you can see that so many vitamins also boost that production of collagen. This whole vitamin helps to produce more and more of collagen in your body. You see why collagen is highly needed for you. So guys, another vitamin that is highly needed, hey, when I mean highly needed, is vitamin E. Vitamin E is a great antioxidant. Vitamin E serves as a great moisturizer. It moisturizes you from the inside. It also moisturizes you from the outside. Yeah, the one I'll recommend is the liquid vitamin E. You can just check my description box. You'll see the link to get a supplement. The one that comes in that liquid form, you can drink. And again, you can add little into your lotion, then apply on your skin. So I will advise that if you're the type that you're always found under the sun, you are the type that always hustle, you're always going under the sun, please consume vitamin E a lot. Add a little of vitamin C in your lotion because it is an antioxidant. Vitamin E helps in fighting those free radicals damage that you might get due to harshness or the heavy sun. And again, if you're the type that you're always consuming vitamin E, this especially I recommend to those of you applying bleaching or lightening skincare product, because you notice most of the women that are into skin lightening probably they want to have a baby and they have to add that baby through CS. You now notice that they're finding hard to stitch their tummy, or they're finding hard, or their tummy finding hard to heal up after having their baby. Yeah, this is because you're doing skin lightening, and at the same time you just have to leave your skin. The chemical or the ash chemical in that skincare product is eating you up. Now if you're the type that you're always on vitamin E despite the fact that you're doing skin lightening, at least you cannot have such issue, because you're applying skin lightening product and at the same time you're trying to protect yourself, your skin, and you're trying to protect your body from the inside. So I hope you see why you really need vitamin E, especially for those of you doing skin lightening. Yeah, you really need it. Even if you're not doing skin lightening, you need it. Have you seen a dark person being burnt by the sun, having sunburn? I've seen such cases so many times. So don't even feel like it is only when you're fair that you can get burnt by the sun. I've seen a whole lot of dark people having sunburn. I've seen such cases a whole lot of time. So you can get burnt by the sun despite your skin color. Always make sure you're on antioxidant vitamins, or make sure you always apply a lotion that contains an antioxidant in them. If you're into skin lightening, I advise you get this vitamin E, because it will really really do you a lot of good. It will help your wound scar to heal fast. Especially, see, we don't know what might happen anytime. You might mistakenly get a scar. Now if you're the type that you're doing heavy bleaching and your skin cannot even protect itself, I advise that you should place yourself on vitamin E. It will really help your skin a lot. Vitamin E is very very important. I give my kids vitamin E. I take vitamin E because I still want to have one more baby, so don't mind me. So the last but not the least, I'll be talking about my one and only omega 3 fatty acid. Like seriously guys, when I was using this, people were asking me, oh, what are you using, what are you using? And see, let me tell you the truth, I don't have time to cream my body. Most time I just apply cream. Once, I don't have time. But when I'm giving out my lotion to clients, all because I want that lotion to work, I will give you serious money. Make sure you apply this lotion on your skin twice daily. Make sure you apply twice daily. But even if I say that I'm talking, don't mind me, or don't do the way I do. Or don't follow my footsteps, or please. Okay, guys, so let me talk about my omega-3 fatty acid. Omega-3 fatty acid can be gotten from salmon. Yeah, salmon fish. Yeah, it can also be gotten from flax seed. Yeah, flaxseed oil actually is rich in omega-3. Then also you can get your omega-3 from chia seed. You can get your omega-3 from chia seed. Omega-3 fatty acid have been shown to help in protecting you from the sun damage. It has been shown to help in protecting you from sagging skin. It has been proven that it helps to firm or it helps wrinkled skin. It has also been proven to help skin inflammation. It has also been proven to help in slowing down aging process. If you are into skin lightening, you need omega-3 fatty acid, you need vitamin E, you need collagen. Please, you need collagen, because skin lightening eats up your flesh gradually. So you need collagen to help your skin. You need collagen to support your skin lightening products. I know what I'm saying, and I know why I am saying this. Especially if you are a woman. If you are a woman who is not married yet, or you've not even given birth, you've not had any baby yet, and you're doing heavy skin lightening, please. Make sure you place yourself on collagen. You need collagen a whole lot. You also need vitamin C. Vitamin C makes your skin popping. Vitamin C actually has lightening properties in them. It makes your skin popping. Now, if you're using a lightening cream, you are using lightening lotion, and you place yourself on vitamin C, you will see the effectiveness of that lightening lotion. Forget the glutathione supplements that everybody shouts on. The only way I support you taking glutathione for skin lightening is when you take the IV. The IV is the injection. You take it through the vein. Yeah, they give you through the vein. So and even at taking this glutathione injection, you have to take so many doses in a week, because it actually has a section. You have to go for sections of it. But when you book, you definitely have sections on which you have to complete the dosage of the particular glutathione milligram that is supposed to go into your body. So, and it's very expensive, my dear. It's not a small money. Glutathione injection is not a small money. So many people, they prefer to like buy these glutathione pills. I don't really believe in glutathione pills, because you get little to no difference in using glutathione pills. I've used it before. But the glutathione injection, from the person I know of, someone that placed herself on glutathione injection, and she was doing fine, but it is quite expensive. So now, if you're doing skin lightening, ascorbic acid, you can place yourself on ascorbic acid. Vitamin C is very, very, in fact, important for you. You really need it, because apart from the antioxidant properties, apart from protecting your skin, it also helps your skin in glowing. Your skin will radiate. Your skin will glow. So, these are the 5 vitamins I recommend for supporting your skin lightening journey, so as to have a glowing and a clearer skin. Believe me, even if you are on this supplement and you don't always apply lotion on your skin 24/7, your skin will be popping. People will still be asking you, what are you applying? They will know that it's what you're eating, because you're eating those vitamins. They will know that the secret behind the popping of your skin is in what you eat, the vitamins you've been feeding your skin. So guys, thank you so much for your support so far. For those of you who have actually bought from my Amazon store, yeah, I really appreciate you. Thank you very much. And know that you are helping me a lot by buying from that Amazon store. And whenever you purchase through my link, I have a certain commission that comes to me. Thank you so much for purchasing from my link so far. To all of you that have purchased, I say I love you guys. Thank you so much. God bless you. And I promise to always be a good girl. Yeah, I promise to always be a good girl. Thank you so much. So if you've not subscribed to my YouTube channel, kindly subscribe to my YouTube channel, like and share my video, and don't forget to turn on your notification bell so that you'll be notified when I upload a new video. And don't forget to drop your opinion. Should I continue with whitening, or should I continue with promixing or organics, or do you want me to combine the two, or you want me to stick on one? I need your opinion. Kindly drop your opinion so that let me know which path to follow. I really want to please you guys, you know. Let me know the path to follow. Thank you guys. I love you. Bye. And happy quarantine. Stay safe. Stay indoor. Make sure you always sanitize. Make sure you wash your hand. Make sure you always put on your hand glove and your nose mask. Stay safe. Thank you. Bye.